सो अवतार मेहर
मेहर
बाबा
मेहर बाबा
की
की जय।
जय। अवतार
अवतार मेहर बाबा
मेहर
की
बाबा
जय।
की जय।
अवतार मेहर
अवतार
बाबा
मेहर बाबा
की
की
जय।
जय।
बाबा की जय जय।
सो थैंक यू
थैंक
प्रताप अंकल फॉर ज्वाइनिंग इन।
यू बाबा।
एवरीबॉडी वाज ईगरली वेटिंग। सो ऑल योर्स ओवर टू यू एंड ऑल योर्स फ्रॉम योर। थैंक यू जय
थैंक यू
बाबा।
थैंक यू थैंक यू सो मच। Some years when I was in service, one of my friends, very close friends in Mumbai, I always had very tough time during the month of January, February, and March. Even in our official duties, it was very tough time for me. And for outside activities also, it had been a very tough time for me. Tough time bodily, mentally. And when I talked this to my friend Sam Patel, he asked me as to when I met Baba in Mahabaleshwar all alone, one on one. That's what's the. So I told him that it must have been in the first week of January 51. And then he said that may be the reason why you are having a tough time during January, February, March. Some process must be there, which Baba must be working on you. And whenever I have observed very closely, I really found that it is really those 3 months were very tough time for me. And at present also, I just have a little worry about these programs which we are having for the birthday functions. Ganesh knows about it. And there are a lot of things to be done, And a lot of queries are there, but a lot of adjustments are there and all that. Expenses and everything has to be looked after. So this seemed to be a tough time always for us. Anyway, now leaving aside the subject, this is the answer to Angela's question. leaving that aside, I'm not much worried about that. Now, I intend to tell you some of the incidents in the life of Dr. Gani, his contact with Meher Baba. I had already started the subject earlier, and I'm just going to continue that subject today. But it may or may not be completed today because there are still certain things which need to be told to you. Dr. Gani's relation with Meher Baba, as I said last time, it was something very, very spiritual relation, in the sense that one thing that he was from childhood, he was Baba's friend. They have played together, they have fought together, they have sat together, they have done everything together. And thereafter, there was a big gap, and thereafter he comes back and then again meet Meher Baba and keeps on coming and going to Meher Baba, and Baba wants to draw him to him. And in the meantime, Dr. Gani gets married and he gets children and all that. So there's a tussle in between his family life and the spiritual life. Baba is drawing him, Baba is pulling him, whereas he has been, his feet have been dug into his family life. That was the condition, in fact, in Gani's case. But then this had expression at times through his talks or through his compositions. he used to express it, and he was a little bit of a outspoken person. Whatever he feels, he will speak out. But then after he, when he got full conviction about Mary Baba's divinity, that took little time, because one can imagine that yesterday's friend, your friend, your own friend with whom you have played, you have done all that masti, you have run here and there, and you have fought with each other and all that. He comes here, he comes and claims that he is God in human form. It's hard to believe. And that was a tough time for both. Mehr Baba wanted to draw him closer to him. Ganip didn't agree to that. Ultimately, Baba had said that I'll bring it to me on a pistol point. On a pistol point, I'll bring to him. And he did that. Now, anyway, after Gani joined Baba, there have been several incidents when one thing that his nature was very humorous nature, witty. He was full of humor, full of wit. And Baba was full of mischiefs. So that both had that play of playing together through some sarcastical statements, sarcastic talks, teasing each other and all that used to be there always. And that was perhaps a relief time for Mehr Baba. But then one thing which I have noticed was, last time also I expressed that there were, in the early times after Baba got kiss from Baba Jan and he went into that state of spiritual ecstasy, that was about 9-11 months, and thereafter when he came back to his normal consciousness, that was a long gap. And after he came to normal consciousness, Gani happened to meet him, and thereafter Baba started him pulling towards himself. Now, due to some incident which I had explained last time, it happened in Lonavala. He was to commit suicide because of some attachments which was brought on his property in Lonavala. And thereafter, Baba brought him to the ashram, and Baba had given a statement to the police that when this incident of that killing of that moneylender had happened, Gani was in my ashram, and that is how he was saved from there. But then it took little time for Gani to accept Baba, because ashram life, ashram Baba, according to him, it was very much idle life, not ideal. It was idle life, just going sitting before Baba and then coming back, and no reading, no chatting and all that. So he was, just bored of that life. And he was said that, Baba, at least give me some books to read, because I'm very much fond of reading books. And here I don't have any books to read even. And then Baba gave him a choice. You make a choice of the books you want. And Baba provided all the books. And this man, he took out some very tricky and very, very significant questions from the spiritual questions, which he used to ask to Baba, and Baba used to, in a spontaneity, he used to give answers, very satisfactory answers to that. That brought some conviction in Dr. Gani. But then, once he was convinced about that, thereafter, he never looked back. He had full conviction. Whatever he used to tell us, that this is the costliest diamond which I am giving in your hand. This is the costliest diamond which I am giving in your hand. Don't lose it even at the cost of your life. Take care of it. That is what he used to say. And Then, of course, he allotted much of his lifetime in either meeting Baba or talking to people about Meher Baba. And training young boys and young girls like us. We were so very young. In fact, I was just in a high school. So we didn't have much of maturity in our thinking and maturity in our behavior and all that. But then he was such a person that he used to convince us. I specifically remember so many incidents which he had narrated to us because I used to be very attentive. Even when I used to sit before Baba, I used to be very attentive as what is happening around. So during that time, after this continued for a couple of years, say, and thereafter Baba announced his new life, and Gadi joined Baba's new life. He had told us that Baba insisted that Gani should accompany him on the new life because Gani's nature and Gani's health condition was not very good to undertake that long journeys on foot and then starving and irregularity in food and inequity in all that discomforts, facing all these discomforts. His nature was such, his life was such that one thing that he was a very easygoing person and he was not inclined to accompany Baba, but then Baba wanted him to accompany Baba in the new life. And then he accompanied Baba in the new life. And believe me, the first heart attack which he got, it was a light heart attack, but which he got after, say, about 40, 50 kilometers must have been there. So there he got first heart attack. Baba asked him to sit under a tree for some time and rest for some time. Thereafter, he started walking. So in all Baba's mission, all his avataric mission, Baba's first priority was to complete that mission. And while doing that, he at times did not care even for the companions who were accompanying Baba. That is one very notable thing in Meher Baba's whole system of working. Every time when Erich used to drive Baba, Erich had said just before Satara accident, Erich had told me that I was so very tired that I was not able to see the road. And my eyes to, I mean, I automatically close. My eyelids used to fall down. And I was all the time worried, but so I mean, dash some tree or some vehicle or some, and but some accident may take place. This was his worry. But then look at Baba's attitude. Baba would say, "You are such an expert driver. You have been driving me for so many years, and I always have praise for you. You are so very careful and expert driver. So you know you have to drive me." And Erich had just to obey Baba. So this was Baba's method of work. He was very much concerned about his mission, which is at hand. And in that mission, accomplish that mission, he at times used to be careless about his companions also. So this had happened in Dr. Gani's case. during some of the funny incidents which I would like to tell today is during Baba's stay in Bangalore. Baba's stay in Bangalore. Baba used to go for a bus tour and all. So usually for bus tour, either RH will be invariably there. But amongst the other, either Kakabar will be there or Agabedul will be there. Or such some such person will be there to accompany Baba for a bus tour. And for the rest of the people who are in the ashram, Baba would allot some duties to each one. So once it so happened that must have been in the early 30s, must be 37, 38, sometime. It was in Bangalore ashram. What had happened is that Gani was Baba. Whenever Baba is out of the ashram, he has gone out, so Gani will be the manager of the whole arrangement. Gani will be the manager, and then Aga Baidul was given the duty of kitchen, purchase of vegetables and this and. Just to see after the food supply and all that. So Aga Baidul was in charge of the kitchen. Gani was allotted of overall supervision. Now Baba had said, while allotting this duty, Baba had said that whoever spends money economically, he will please me. One who saves money, he will please me. And Aga Baidul took it very seriously. When Baba said that one who saves money, he will please me, Aga Baidul took it very seriously, and he was in charge of the kitchen. What he did, he purchased heaps of pumpkin, and then started feeding the whole Mandali people. For the morning breakfast, it will be something of that out of that pumpkin. In the afternoon meal, it will be for out of that pumpkin. In the evening, it will be out of that pumpkin. So for all the three services, it will be this pumpkin is a common vegetable. No other vegetable, but it was very cheap those days. And he had purchased heaps of this pumpkin. You understand this pumpkin, no? That vegetable. Now, what had happened that the Mandali was just got bored of eating that pumpkin for the morning breakfast, for the afternoon lunch, and for the evening supper and all that. They were very much bored of that. And not only that, but many people were having loose motions. Many people have some stomach troubles and all that. And now, nobody was allowed, nobody was, Baba never liked anybody complaining against anybody. Nobody was supposed to complain. Now when, after some few days, Baba came back to the ashram after finishing his outside job, when he came back, how to complain to Baba? That was the problem. That was the question before everybody. Everybody was wondering as to how this matter has to be brought in Baba's notice. So they approached Dr. Gani. They approached Dr. Gani, and after Gani was also having the same problem, but then they very emphatically said to Dr. Gani that you do something to save us from this pumpkin eating. And the fertile head of Dr. Gani, he composed a song. The wording of that song is, Mere Baidul ne kola pakaya hai aaj. Kola means that pumpkin. My Baidul, that person, Baba's Mandali one, my Baidul has cooked this pumpkin today. Mere Baidul ne kola pakaya hai aaj. And then that song goes on about 2-3 stanzas. And one singer from Pune, he had gone there by name Kambade, Babu Kambade. He was asked to sing this song when Baba wants some singing. Baba used to ask for some singing, and anybody present there, he would ask that person to sing. So this Babu was there, and Baba asked to sing before him, just to entertain him, just to for relaxation. And this song, which he had learned from Dr. Gani, he started singing. And Baba could understand. There is something wrong. Baba could understand. And then he said, who has composed this song? He said, no, he said, Dr. Gani has composed this song. Then he called Dr. Gani. What is the meaning of this song? And then Gani took a chance to explain to Baba, Baba, this man who is, you have asked him to just, you have told him that whoever pleases him through economy, he Baba will be pleased with that person. And this Baidul, he has purchased heaps of this pumpkin, vegetable pumpkin, and every time he is just feeding that to people, and people are getting sick because of that. One thing that they are feeling nauseatic about that. Another thing that they are having loose motions. Another thing they are having lot of stomach troubles. And now how to save them? No complaint is to be made to you. So I thought of composing some song so that it will, by that way we can open this topic if you want. And then Baba called Aga Baidul, and he took him to task. We say, this is not the way of, economizing as I intended, as I suggested. It is you are troubling these people. And he visited him with him the room where all these vegetables were kept, this pumpkin. And Baba asked him to bury all that which was purchased, which are lying there. Everything was buried in a big pond, this thing, and they were saved out of this. So that was Dr. Gani's idea. Another thing which was a very significant thing is that in the ashram of this must have been in Rahuri ashram, Gani once complained to Baba that, Baba, what is this life? We have been living with you for so many years, but we are not able to even perform even the smallest miracle. So what is the use of our staying in this ashram? So Baba said, is it? You want to perform something, some miracles? Yes, Baba, I must get some powers. We are living with you, and so we must get some powers. So Baba said, I can give you, provided you do whatever I ask you to do. If you do that, even if you take out your clothes, go to the burial ground and put ash on your body and sit there And whoever comes there, even if you pick up some clay from that or from ash from there and give to somebody, he will get benefited. His desire will be fulfilled, the person who comes there. So this power I can give you. You say, if you say yes, you go and go naked and sit there in the burial ground. And Ganesh says, no, that sort of a miracle, I don't want that sort of a powers. These are this type of powers I don't want. I want to live a very luxurious life. I will be there sitting on a throne-like chair, and people will be waving fans around me. And on one side, there will be a very sumptuous food being cooked. And on the other side, there will be some dancer dancing before me. And I'm enjoying that powers, those powers, spiritual powers, sitting there, watching all these things. That type of life I want. Not this going in this smashan and sitting there and putting ash on your body. Not that type. I want this type. So Baba said, all right, I can give you that also. But then you have to follow what I say. If you are able to do that, you will get this, whatever you want. And then, yes, Baba, tell me what I am supposed to do. And Baba said that, live on water for 6 months. This is one option. Another option is live on milk for 3 months. If you complete this, then you will get all the powers which you desired. Dr. Ganesh said that, yes, I will live on milk for 3 months. I accept that. But then he warned Meher Baba, Dr. Ganesh warned Meher Baba, that I am from tomorrow, I will be observing this diet, taking milk. Whenever I feel hungry, I'll take milk only, not even water, taking milk only. For 3 months, I will complete that. But during that period, you should never tease me. Show pity on me, because you have got bad habit. You have a bad habit that you tease me and then I will get disturbed. So that, if you promise that, I will start. No, I will. Baba said, I will not tease you. I am just allow you to observe your fast. And he started fast very seriously from the very next day. And Dr. Ganesh had told us that I was feeling so very nauseating about this milk, for morning breakfast milk. For any thirst, I have to take milk. For afternoon meals, I have to take milk. For evening tea, I have to take milk. For night meals, I have to take milk. So for all these, wherever I feel hungry or wherever I feel thirsty, I have to take milk. As a result, I was feeling so weary that the moment I used to see milk, I used to get like vomiting. This is one thing. And another thing, even people started, when they come close to me, they started smelling milk. My body was giving smell of milk. It was to that extent. But then he said that I was very much desperate in observing this, because I wanted to test this Meher Baba. He has promised me to give these powers and all that. So I will complete this fast according to his instructions. whatever may happen to me. And about 3-4 days were left. Baba comes to him and with a very sad face, he says to Dr. Gani, "You are looking so very pale. I really get much worried about you. And I don't feel that you will be able to live any longer. And then a very significant gesture which Baba had done was he announced to the people, to the Mandali people then, that Gani is going to die. Dr. Gani is going to die because of this fast which is continuing. And there were only few days left, 5-6 days left. And that Baba is declaring to before the people that Gani is going to die. And what he did that he instructed the Mandali to bring coffin for his burial, prepare everything for his burial, bring the priest for offering the prayers, and every arrangement of Gani's burial was done there with the coffin, with the flowers, with the priest, everything was there. And it was placed in the compound. All the people gathered together. And what Baba did is that Baba himself entered the coffin, lied there for some time and came out. And then asked them to close it. And then asked people as Mandali to take a procession, a death procession of that coffin, and then bury it. And that was done, and Baba had made him to break that fast. Dr. Gani used to tell us that it was a sort of transformation of life. During those times, I was very young, we could not understand what is that transformation of life, or something to do that Baba has saved his life. So this is another incident, very significant incident in the life of Dr. Gani. When in Mehrabad, there were many Westerners, especially Norina Majbili, Elizabeth Patterson, and with the dancers, so many people were there, lady members. And it was in Mehrabad Ashram, and Baba had asked all those, Katie Devi was there, all that Baba had asked to write an article on avatar. On the subject of avatar, those who are fond of writing, they should write an article on avatar and bring to Baba. Baba will be sitting in a assemblage of people, all the Mandali people, ladies and gents, they will be sitting, and Baba will be sitting there, and that person who has written that article, he has to come and read it before everyone. Now, turn by turn, every day, different people, turn by turn, they have to come. And once, when the turn of Dr. Gani came, Gani had written his article on avatar. And what Gani thought, that every day, whenever people have to read articles before Baba, Baba comes little late by 5 minutes or 10 minutes, and people keep on waiting for him, then he will come and take his seat, and then that person who has to read his article, he will read the article. that day when Dr. Gani's turn was there, Gani thought that Baba every day comes little bit late by 5-10 minutes. So he wanted to have go through the whole article, make some alterations here and there, some words, and some adjustment of sentences, and just to polish his article. And as his habit, very lethargically, slowly walking, he's just walking the hall where Baba was seated, already seated, and all the people were waiting for Dr. Gari to come. Now this man very leisurely goes inside, and everybody's looking at Dr. Gani with a thought that how this man is going to face now Baba, because Baba is sitting here for such a long, and this man is coming leisurely, and what will be the reaction now? Now Dr. Gani came and Baba took him to task. Baba just fired him and said, "Why you are late?" And Gani very innocently said that, "Baba, every day you come little bit. I have observed that all these days, whenever any article was to be read, you have come late by 5 minutes or 10 minutes. So I just took a chance to reread the article and make some adjustment and make some polishing of that. And when I came here, I found that you are already seated here." So Baba calls him near and gives him such a hard slap. Such a hard slap that Dr. Me said that for a second I had this a sort of a little bit of sense of unconsciousness, something like that. And then again he started abusing him. "You always do like this, you all take it very lightly, and you are of no use, and you some sort of thing like that." And he is pointing Dr. Gani to ask the people, all these people sitting, ask them what time I have come here. And everybody said that Baba has come 10 minutes earlier. So Gani has no answer for that. Then Baba again, after a few abuses, he again calls him near. And this time Gani said that I thought that now Baba had given me already one very hard slap. Now if you will caress me and ask me to read the article. But Baba instead gave him another slap on another cheek. Very hard slap. And he felt like fainting. And immediately Baba asked, "Now start reading your article." And wasting even a second, Gani opened his pages and started reading the article. And this article which Gani had written turned out to be the best one amongst all these articles. And he won the prize. That prize was a suit, trousers and coat and all that. A full suit. He won that prize. And then Baba asked him, "When I slapped you and asked you to read the article, how you could do that immediately?" So he said, "I had committed mistake. After all, you are my childhood friend. So I just forgive you." And Baba said, "You are a really shameless person." And then all the other people were wondering how this man, after having got two very hard slaps, he could read article as if nothing has happened to him. So that was Dr. Gani. Now, in Bangalore Ashram, what had happened is that Dr. Gani was appointed as the overall management of this whole ashram. Whenever Baba is not there, Baba is present, not present there. So there was some sort of a miscalculation or something must be there. His these calculations were not tallying. His expenditure and then receipts and what money matter were not tallying. And he was getting worried about this because every pie is to be counted, every pie is to be had to be explained to Baba. Now what to do? He was very much worried about that. Some funds were spent and he was not able to find out as to on what things he has spent that amount. He had checked his all the papers in there, but he was not able to find out. So what he thought that he will sell off that suit which had won in that article. He thought of selling it and he put it for auction. When he put it for auction, this Dr. Nilkant Godse, he got very much upset. He said, you have won this, you have been given this as a prize for winning this. You have won this prize for giving this article and you are selling it. This is nonsense. Actually, it's not allowed in the ashram. You are going against the discipline of the ashram. And Nehru got very much upset about it. But then Gani didn't care for that. He said, no, I have to make up with that money and I will sell it off. And Vishnu Master, he purchased it, making up that amount which was falling short. He gave that amount to Dr. Gani and he had purchased that suit. But then from the backhand, Nilkant Godse purchased that from Vishnu Master. In turn, Vishnu Master sold it to Nilkant Godse. And when Baba returned to the ashram, it was reported to Baba that such and such thing had happened. And Gani has broken the discipline of the ashram. And Baba reprimanded Dr. Gani as to this is against the rules and regulations of the ashram. Don't you have shame in doing that and all that? Baba abused me. But Dr. Gani said that Baba, there is only one person who had been very much honest and very much against in my breaking the discipline of this ashram. And that person was Dr. Nilu. He was not allowing me to sell that suit. But then somehow I had to get money and so I had to sell it off. But then he was so very honest, Dr. Nilu, that he criticized me for breaking the discipline of the ashram. He criticized me, but from backhand, he himself purchased a suit from Vishnu Master. And Baba had a good laugh. And then quarrels among the Mandali people and Baba used to enjoy at times all these matters. Gani's nature was very witty nature. He used to call these moneyed people, those who are well-to-do persons, business people, especially among the Mandali, among the Mandali who are not residing with Baba, but not resident, but other Mandali members who were in business. Dr. Gani used to call them as spiritual black marketers. Spiritual black marketeers. That is the word Baba Dr. Gani used to have this for these people. The reason is that those people who were living with Baba, there were expenses, and there were some selected people who used to finance Baba for these. But then those people who used to finance for maintenance of these people, they used to look down on the members who are living there, because they are not paying anything. They aren't able to pay, they are not earning anything, they are not paying anything. And the burden falls on these business people. So they used to have some sort of a look down upon these people. And that is why Dr. Gani used to call them as spiritual black marketeers. In our early time, when Madhusudan used to compose songs for Mehr Baba's name, he used to use that word Meherji in song. Whenever there is a name of Mehr Baba, he will sing as Meherji, Meherji. And once Dr. Gani told him, you change that word. You change that word Meherji. Don't use that word Meherji, because this is one another Meherji. In Baba's fold, there is another Meherji who is a businessman. So people will mistake him with this word. So you change this word. And thereafter, Madhusudan started to use Meherba. Instead of Meherji, he started using Meherba. And that is how the whole names were changed in all his songs. Dr. Gani's relation with us was so very, he had a special place in Baba's heart. Because of Dr. Gani's close association with Pune people, especially the young group of Pune, the young group of Pune had a good name and fame amongst all Baba lovers, among Baba circles. We were recognized as Dr. Gani group. People used to recognize us as a Gani group. Even Baba used to say that this is a Gani group. These Pune boys, young boys and girls, they are Dr. Gani's group. Because Gani has focused all his attention in developing the understandings, the convictions and the conceptions of all the young group. And all the other young groups, they were also capable because they had one-pointed faith in Mehr Baba. Without knowing even the exact greatness of these personalities, but then they simply by hearing Dr. Gani's lectures and reading few books, they had developed that conviction in themselves, and they used to take Baba as Baba says. Once it so happened that I was sitting in Guru Prasad. In fact, there were no members of our group. I was alone, but then Baba's other Mandali were there. The senior people were there. Some people from Mumbai were there. Nariman and Jim Mistry and Baba's other member who are living with Baba. They were present and they were discussing about one couplet which was in Urdu. Now, because of our association with Dr. Ghani, close association with Dr. Ghani, and because of the chances which we got to listen to Urdu ghazals, which were sung before Baba, we had developed some liking and little bit of understanding also. So when there was a discussion going on in Guru Prasad, when one couplet was being discussed and everybody was experiencing his own opinion on the meaning of that couplet, and now Baba is listening to everybody. Baba is, all these senior people, they are having their own version about this meaning of this couplet of the ghazal. I was the youngest one sitting there listening to everything. But then by that time, because of my singing hobby, I had understood some of the ghazals. So I expressed my opinion about that verse, what it means. And all the senior people, they're shocked off. Hey, what this boy? And their expression was as if, what this yesterday's a boy I can understand about these Urdu ghazals, which are of high meaning. And they just shrugged off my say. But then Baba said, no, don't shrug off his whatever he says, don't shrug off that, because here Baba says, because he is from Dr. Ghani group. That was the recognition. How Baba felt about Dr. Ghani. So that was when Baba said that he is from Dr. Ghani group. So that was the weightage Dr. Ghani was having in that whole group. It was a really wonderful incident which I had with Baba there. This man, I think I will be able to complete last part. We see a little bit of sad part. Dr. Ghani is passing away, and he is coming back from the new life. That portion is a little bit sad, so I kept it. The whole portion I kept it separate for next session. Today I will tell you something about some other incident which happened in Pune. As we all know that, Ganesh, I think we have little time.
You have all the time. It's up to you. Don't worry.
Yeah. So I'll just complete this one story. During those days, some of our people in Pune Center, especially our secretary K.K. Ramakrishnan, he was a very capable person. Before that, just now a thought comes to my mind that the Pune Center, so many people, so many Baba people, senior Baba people have expressed that Pune Center has been so very fortunate, so very blessed by, because Baba has provided so many very capable persons. And believe me, K.K. Ramakrishnan was a wonderful person. But then we had Dr. Ghani with us. We had association with Khang Sahib. We had association with Behli Irani. We had guidance from Ramchandra Gadekar. And so many people, and so many whoever comes to Pune, he will just visit our center and be with us. So we were really fortunate enough to have conversation, association with all these senior people. And that way, Pune Center has been very lucky, very, very fortunate. Now coming to the story, K.K. Ramakrishna was in a habit of spreading Baba's message. He was a graduate in Christianity. He had studied Bible and he had acquired a graduation certificate from the Spicer College in Pune. So he had that habit of taking bicycle, taking pamphlets, and along with another person who was a railway ticket collector by name Bhavsar. Both of them will go on bicycle to villages, collect the people, tell them about Mir Baba, and distribute the pamphlets and come back. That used to be their activities for quite some time. We never indulged into that sort of activity. We never liked that. But then, because of K.K. Ramakrishna's close association with this Christianity, the missionary type of work, perhaps he must be doing that for some time. But then, once it so happened that we have festivals, yearly festivals, in the name of some deity of that village or that area. Now, take for example, Babajan Darga. So Babajan Darga, it is called a Urs. Urs means the yearly festival. So they have all festive mood. There is singing, there is people come for darshan, and lot of things they do. Such function was there in an area called Dapudi. Dapudi is an area in Pune, outskirts of Pune. So there was such a yearly festival in the name of some peer, some darga of a peer. And we were very, very fond of going, attending to such festivals, just for fun, not with any another intention, just for fun. There used to be wrestling, there used to be some merry-go-round, there used to be so many games, so many things. So we would just take around and enjoy, and then in the evening time, late evening time, so much of rush will be there. There will be beating of drums. There will be singing, there were this and that and all that. All halla-gulla. Lot of noise. So one such a place, Dapudi, there was a festival, and our secretary, K.K. Ramshan, had arranged for a Baba program during that festival. That festival was for about three days. So on one of the days, he had arranged our program at that place. He thought that so many people will be there. We will have a good bhajan program here. We will have a good talk about Baba. And so many people will hear about Baba, listen to what Baba's message and all that. And accordingly, he talked with it local people of that area and urgent for a program. Now take the, just look at the scene. We, according to the timing, we never missed any such a program. We were very sincere in attending such programs. We were very sincere in observing the timing and all. Without any expectations, we will take our own instruments on bicycles. We will have our own arrangements and then attend those programs and come back. So our group, we went there. Now look at the scenery. There is a big tree around which there is a platform. our sitting arrangement over there on that platform of that platform around that tree. In Marathi, it is called par, P-A-R, par. On that, we were supposed to sit, and there were microphones. Our bhajan, then talk, and then aarti and prayers. This was the program. When we had just mind well, all around there is a lot of noise, lot of sound, big sound, big noise. Everywhere there is a festival atmosphere, and then there will be a lot of sound, and but we are supposed to sing there. And unfortunately for us, that lights went off, the electricity failed, and our mic stopped working. Now, in that noisy atmosphere, we were supposed to sing, supposed to put our whole energy for singing. And believe me, the speaker was Barnatu, who was very thin and frail person. He, even if he shouts loudly, it may reach few people sitting right in front of us. And in that atmosphere, we did that program, and throughout the program, the light never came back. And we had to carry on with that program. After that program, we went to our respective houses, and next Sunday, there was a complaint against us, against the bhajan party, saying that, Baba, we arrange programs, outside programs, in order that people should hear your names. And these bhajan mandali people, they don't cooperate properly with us. That was the complaint made against the bhajan mandali. And I do not know why, but every such a time, Baba would ask me to get up and tell what had happened. So I was asked to get up. And Baba said, what these people complain about, you people? What had happened? What has happened? Why you people do that? So I explained the whole thing to Baba. Baba, this was the fact that there was this Urus, and Baba knew that how that Urus takes place, because Baba has attended that several times. So Baba, that was Urus, that was a yearly festival, and all around there was so much of noise. And in that, we didn't have mic, that mic system failed. And we had to sing before the people, and Barnathu had to give a talk. When I explained the whole thing, Baba said to Ramakrishnan and the other people who were complaining against us, that you should always think these people now. See what he says, whether it is correct, whether what he explains, what he describes is correct. Had this happened like that? So they said, yes, Baba, it was like that. Then how you expect them to have they stopped singing? Have they refused singing? No. Then how you say that they are not cooperating with you? And Baba, I mean, just fired those people. And said, that time Baba had said some certain things. Baba said, don't take the singers lightly. They have their own capacity. There should be good atmosphere. These are the things Baba is telling them. There should be good environments where they are performing. There should be good sitting arrangement where they are performing. There should be good instruments. There should be good listeners and the mic system. And above that, over and above that, Baba said that they should have a good mood. They should have a good mood to sing. So remember these things. And further, Baba said that I know singing. What is singing? Baba is telling about himself. I know what is singing. So I can understand their feelings. When you blame them for certain things, I can understand their feelings. They are not at fault. In such an atmosphere, how much you can expect from them? Baba had to completely taken our side and then he settled the whole matter. Now with this, I think I will be, I will say goodbye to all of you. For next session, perhaps next session, I'll be completing Dr. Gnumi. It's a little bit of very emotional portion, emotional part of our Dr. Gani's life. And even whenever I narrate that and I remember that, what a ordeal he had to undergo, Dr. Gani, that I will describe next time. So today, Jai Baba to all of you, and thank you so much for any question you may have, they may please ask me.
Anybody, any questions? It was a very beautiful session. Thank you, Pratap Kaka.
So, Jai Baba, thank you.
Very beautiful. So anybody, any questions? You can unmute themselves and ask.
Pratamkal, I have a question. Jai Baba.
Nimesh.
Jai Baba. I am happy that you are asking the question. You have a question.
Because you just alluded to one topic when you said that Dr. Gani had asked Baba to give certain powers, okay, and yes. He was asked to fast on milk. So, yes. I also heard that Baba had made a formal agreement, legal agreement, that you enter into an agreement and both of us will sign as parties to the agreement. And if I failed to give you that, you can actually challenge.
I have heard, but not from Dr. Gani. I had learned about this thing, but not from Dr. Gani. I especially tell whatever we have heard from directly from Dr. Gani. So that agreement part, he has not, he must have omitted from us. That is why I have not expressed my opinion on that. But yeah. I heard about it. I heard about it.
Okay. Nice. And one more incident about the puzzle, if you can share, if you must have heard that Dr. Gani used to solve puzzles.
It was in my mind to narrate that, but then during the time I just forgot about it. There are two things which I would like to add. One is that Dr. Gani had written, when Dr. Gani had written articles on Avatar, he had given one article for the Illustrated Weekly of India. He had given one article for Illustrated Weekly of India, and he had won the first prize for that article. And when he told Baba that I have won this first prize, and told Baba what was the first prize, what amount was that, and what Baba had said is, "You have sold me very cheap. You have sold me very cheap." Anyway, now about these puzzles. Dr. Gani, just a big pastime, he was solving some puzzles. And our great master, he will never, I mean, just, I do not know why, but they used to tease each other. Never used to sit quiet. Now, when Dr. Gani is so much engrossed in solving the puzzle, Baba came, and Baba very appreciating this what Gani has doing, and he said that this word is correct word. You put that word, so Gani will change that, and now Godman is telling. So naturally, his word is correct word. So according to Baba's instructions, Dr. Gani will change those words, his own words, and put Baba's words. And the result comes out, it will be exactly opposite. All the words which Baba has said, they will be wrong. And Dr. Gani's words were correct words. Because perhaps Baba never liked that person should indulge into such activities of earning money this way. Perhaps that may be the reason. But otherwise, I don't see any other reason in that. One cannot say, but Baba's, all knowledge, all for all this. So one cannot dare say that Baba will use wrong words. But it was deliberate, must have been deliberate on his part to change that word and put a wrong word there. That used to happen. Ultimately, gradually that habit went off, Dr. Gani. Thank you for reminding me of this incident. So these two incidents were in my mind, but in the course of my talk, I forgot to mention about it. This weekly article was.
Thank you for sharing. Thank you so much. Thank you, Baba.
Thank you. Jai Baba. My pleasure.
Jai Baba.
So, Dinah, you put a comment that you love Pratap Uncle's stories. Yeah.
Thank you, Pratap Ji, as usual. You're delighting us with such intimate stories about Baba and his mandali. It's so very precious. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Jai Baba.
Always good to see.
Thanks,
you.
Baba.
Thank you, Baba.
Thank you, Baba.
Dinah Goodhart comment saying that she likes your, she loves your stories, and she thanks you for it.
Yeah.
Dinah, if you want, you can unmute yourself. Okay, I guess that's what we have for today.
Thank you so much, Pratapji. Your stories are just always so delightful, and I see how much you enjoy telling them. So it's just lovely to spend this time with you. I want to thank you. I always look forward to meeting with you on Fridays.
Jai Baba.
Okay. Anybody, any other question, comments? Okay. Yeah. Anybody having anything?
Jai Baba.
Food for the soul.
Thank you.
Not rice and dal.
yes. Jeff, last meeting when I was, I had talked something about my travel to Myrtle Beach and all that, and I had mentioned your name as my best friend who had met me in Myrtle Beach.
Yeah.
And helped me so much.
And I
you
was
remember you remember those days. I do remember every moment of that.
Oh, definitely. Mm. And you sang and you shared your stories, and it just brings the human side of Baba right here to us.
Yes, miss. So
he's not up in some cloud. He's right down here mingling with us and relating to us. Just beautiful.
During these acts of mischief, Baba's expressions will be altogether like a very common person. His expression, he was the best actor, I would say. A best actor, his expressions will be so very lovely that one cannot say that he is a god man sitting here and having this fun with the people.
Yeah, completely camouflaged if need be.
Yes.
He looks just like Ganesh, you know. Or just some, you know, Joe off the street. But, you know, Darwin used to talk about how Baba would remove the veil sometimes and let you look deeper into him.
Oh.
You know, so sometimes he would be seeing Baba, you know, in his all his splendor, and other people are walking by in the street and they see him more as an ordinary person.
Oh, thanks Baba.
Yeah.
That is a great fortune that we can have, just to feel Baba's presence.
Yeah.
Baba's vibrations and Baba's presence is always there. The other day I had some talk with Ward Parks. He's studying Dr. Gani's diary.
Ah, yeah.
Yes, Ward Parks is studying diary. He had some queries about a song, like new life song.
Oh, yeah.
And we had discussed that with him.
Which is such a beautiful song. I mean, the meaning of it.
Oh, my God. It is really very beautiful. Very, very, very real. I intend to sing one more song. This new long song and new life song I had sung once. But then there is another song which was composed by one professor. He was a good friend of Dr. Gani. He had composed a song on Baba's Parvardigar prayer. A beautiful composition, I would say. I would definitely sing it sometimes when we have a little bit of spare time with us after this talk. We will definitely. It's a beautiful song. Beautiful song.
Yeah, we'll be on the front row seats. You know that New Life song, Baba gave him just one night to write it, right? He had just one night to compose. He had to have it ready the next day, I think. So he composed that so quickly.
Yes.
So the next session will be right next day after Baba's birthday, Pratap Uncle. So this will be on the 26th, which will be right after 25th. So after Baba's birthday, that's when your next session will be.
What day of the week is it?
Friday. So that's okay. Like birthday is on the Thursday, Baba's birthday. So that's 25th is on the Thursday. So 26th, we'll be having Pratap Uncle's next session.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess then. Thank you, Pratap Uncle. This was a very, very valuable session. And hey, Baba, thank you so much.
Yeah.
So thanks, Baba. Thanks, Baba.
We'll conclude with three times Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai. Everyone can unmute themselves and we can all together say Avatar Mer. Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai. Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai.
Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai. Thank you.